Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
What's good, people? TWoo here, and I'm running white hot with this red all-in Goblin Storm deck. We'll see how the matches go. Reality might come down, but I haven't lost yet, 5 matches in. Absurd hands. Check out the sideboard here. It's just 15 first edition Charizards. I haven't boarded, and I can't lose right now, but I mean, again, I haven't recorded the matches yet, so I'm going to talk wild cocky before we get in there. But I mean, basically the idea of this deck is taking the all in red decks, the Goblin Charbelcher decks, and just have YOLO hands where you just say, I believe in the heart of the cards, and you try to do something really dumb on turn two with this deck more. I get a turn one Goblin Rabblemaster. I know some of you guys are thinking, yo, this needs Goblin Guide, it needs Goblin Grenade. It doesn't, but you could build other decks with those cards that are very good too. I think Goblins is pretty stacked in Modern, actually, especially with the addition of Goblin Rabblemaster. It does die to Lightning Bolt, but it's blisteringly fast. You put one of these into play turn one, they can't bolt it, they're just going to die. Like, this thing is blisteringly fast. So, quick empty, quick siege gang, ritual it out. Our deck's half mana, basically, even though we only play 16 lands. Contested war zone to pump the team. Pump, pump, pump them up. Pump, pump, Goblin Chieftain to pump the team and give the empties and the siege gang's haste. And then Bushwhacker to pump the team and give stuff haste. Warren Instigator, because I had a turn one Warren Instigator. I've had so far that connected and dumped 2 siege gangs on the second turn, so YOLO. I mean, this is just the heart of the cards type Goblin deck. I am in love with it. I'm super hot with it. It makes my blood hot, or whatever that Shakespearean term is, but it's just, I don't know, it's everything that I want in a Magic deck today. It's got absurd opening hands. Like, the sample hands of this deck are spicy, my lord. Anyways, we're gonna have fun with it today, so let's jump into the two-mans. Two-mans are knit, yeah. By the way, I guess I'll do a quick rant on the MTGO economy, and you're probably seeing this a week, 2 weeks later, so maybe things bounce back or get worse, but what the hell is going on? Like, singles prices have plummeted dangerously, and if you play in a two-man, even if you win, you lose money, so it's like, why? It's like, why? It's a really bad problem. I think, I suspect lots of people sold out, actually, is probably what happened, which would just drive everything down. And then, I don't know what's going on with the packs exactly, but it's too bad. I think things will bounce up, though, so maybe now or soon is a good time to just stock up on staples, because I don't know how much lower the economy can go, because it's tied to real-life cards. Real-life cards are doing fine. There's no signs of crashing there, so MTGO should bounce back later on. So those are my speculation tip as well, thoughts. So catch you in the matches.